Assalamu alaikum dear students, welcome back to English Honeydews lesson number 4, Bipin Chaudhary's Lapse of Memory part 2, half of the remaining. Okay students, in last video I taught you Bipin Chaudhary's Lapse of Memory part 2 half, and today the half of the remaining of part 2 I will discuss with you. What happened in part 2? I told you that Bipin Chaudhary, when he was got into the car, he thought about the communication held between these two person. These two person, that means who? Mr. Bipin Babu and Mr. Parimal Ghosh. So he was thought about the communication, and he told Sitaram to drive his car by the Ganga River. Then what happened? When the driver was driving his car from by the side of the Ganga, Mr. Bipin Babu thought about the incident which happened. He got confused that if I was at Ranchi and I forget all these things in the which happened in the year 1958, and that person Mr. Parimal Ghosh who looked like very familiar of me, but Mr. Babu doesn't know that person. So he was getting confused that how this person can know about my private life, my personal life. And to check this, first he roll up his trouser. If you go through part 1, you can see that Parimal Ghosh told Mr. Babu that you have a cut on your right knee. So he roll up his trouser to check whether that person is true or not. And finally, he got confirmed that there is a cut on his right knee. So he was trying to recall that from where this cut came on his knee. So we stopped here in our last video. Let's continue. See. Then Bipin Babu suddenly thought of Dinesh Mukherjee. Okay. So when Bipin Babu thought about his childhood, he cannot recall that incident. Then another evidence given by Mr. Parimal Ghosh was about Bipin Babu, was about Dinesh Mukherjee. Dinesh Mukherjee, the man had said that Dinesh was in Ranchi at the same time. Parimal Ghosh told him that Dinesh Mukherjee was with him in the year 1958 at Ranchi. The best thing surely would be to ask him, and Mr. Bipin Babu want confirmation about this incident. So he thought about that if he would ask about this to him, and that Dinesh Mukherjee lived quite near in Beninandan Street, and he know Dinesh Mukherjee because he was his intimate friend. So where he lived near Beninandan Street. Beninandan Street, it lies in Kolkata. What about going right now? But then, if he had really never been to Ranchi, what would Dinesh think if Bipin Babu asked for a confirmation? Then again, Bipin Babu thought that if I will ask him that we were at Ranchi, and if suppose he said no, we were not at Ranchi in the year 1958, then what? He will make a fun of me. He will become a ridiculous. He will become a ridiculous person. And he will think that this how this person can confirm about such an incident. He would probably conclude Bipin Babu was going nuts, and he will become sure that Bipin Babu was going mad. Bipin Babu was going crazy. Here going nuts, that means going mad. You can see here. No, it would be ridiculous to ask him. Then Bipin Babu decided, no, I will not ask him. If I will ask, it would be ridiculous. What's the meaning of ridiculous, students? Ridiculous, that means deserving, foolish. You can say ridiculous, that means foolish. Another meaning is that deserving of ridiculous, absurd. You can also say absurd, ridiculous meaning. See further. And he knew how ruthless Dinesh's sarcasm could be. Dinesh Mukherjee was Bipin Babu's nearly friend, close friend. So he know himself, he know Dinesh Mukherjee. So about his behavior, which type of behavior of Dinesh Mukherjee? He is a sarcasm. Sarcasm, the meaning sarcasm, that means he always create a humor in any matter. So he was that type of person who always make a fun of others. So Bipin Babu was very familiar with Dinesh Mukherjee's behavior. Then he refused to ask him. Now see what happened. Sipping a cold drink in his air-conditioned living room, Bipin Babu felt at ease again. Now he went to his house, in his room. He took a cold drink in his air-conditioned living room, in his room. And Bipin Babu felt at ease again. Here, the at ease again, that means he felt comfortable there. Such a nuisance. Just because they have nothing else to do, they go about getting into other people's hair. Then again he was thinking about this matter, and slowly he was talking to himself that just because they have nothing else to do, a person has nothing to do, they can getting into other people's hair, they can interfering with and annoying people. That means they are always trying to interfere in others' matter. How this could be? How that people are like? So he was thinking he was talking about Parimal Ghosh. After dinner, snuggling in bed with one of the new thrillers, Bipin Babu forgot all about the man in New Market. So after dinner, snuggling in bed, snuggling, that means lying in a bed with one of the new thrillers. One of the new thrillers, that means if he was at a bookstore, and at a bookstore he book he purchases thrillers book, and he was reading that books. So Bipin Babu forgot all about, while reading he forgot all about this incident which took place in New Market. Next day in the office, Bipin Babu noticed that with every passing hour, the previous day's encounter was occupying more and more of his mind. So another day, next day, in the office, Bipin Babu noticed that he noticed that with every passing hour, after an hour, with every hour, the previous day's encounter, the previous day's meeting, encounter here means, that means meeting, was occupying more and more of his mind. More and more of his mind here, that means the matter which happened into New Market comes into his mind again and again. If the man knew so much about Bipin Babu, how could he make such a mistake about the Ranchi trip? And he thought that if the man knows about my life, Bipin Babu's personal life, then how could he make such a mistake? Then how could this person make a mistake about the Ranchi trip? That he knows about my life, everything. He knows about Bipin Babu's my here, that means Bipin Babu's life, everything. But about Ranchi trip, how he, that person can do this mistake? Just before lunch, Bipin Babu decided to ring up Dinesh Mukherjee. So he was thinking, he was going mad by thinking this matter. So he decided to call Dinesh Mukherjee. It was better to settle the question over the phone. So he thought that to settle this question, to solve this matter, I will ring up the Dinesh Mukherjee's phone. At least the embarrassment on his face wouldn't show. Because if the communication took place face to face, then at that time Dinesh Mukherjee will make a fun of Bipin Babu. But if I could, if I will make a call, my embarrassment can't be seen to him. So he decided to call Dinesh Mukherjee and try to solve this investigation. So he dialed the number 235616. Bipin Babu dialed the number. Now Dinesh Mukherjee picked up the phone and said, "Hello, is that Dinesh? This is Bipin here." Now here you can see communication held between these two, Dinesh Mukherjee and Bipin Babu. So Bipin Babu said, "Hello, is that Dinesh? This is Bipin here. Well, well, what's the news?" And in reply, Dinesh Mukherjee said, "Yes, I am Dinesh. And what's the news? I just wanted to find out if you recalled an incident which took place in 58 and Bipin Babu started to ask him that I just wanted to know that if you recalled an incident which took place in the year 1958. 58? What incident? And in reply, Dinesh Mukherjee said, in the year 1958, which incident took place? Were you in Kolkata right through that year? That's the first thing I have got to know. Then Bipin Babu asked him that were you in Kolkata right through that year? During whole year 1958, whole year you were in Kolkata? That's the first thing I have got to know. I want to know that a whole year 1958 you had never been at some other places, some other state. Yeah, you were at Kolkata. Wait, just a minute. And in reply, Dinesh Mukherjee told him, just a minute, in the year 1958, just let me check in my diary that what happened in the year 1958. So by this line we can say that Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee was writing a diary. For a minute there was silence, and for whole minute there was silence because during this silence Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee was trying to find out into diary what happened in the year 1958. So during this silence, Bipin Babu could feel that his heartbeat had gone up. And in this silence, because you can see what happened to Bipin Babu, is it true or not? So Bipin Babu could feel that his heartbeat had gone up. Bipin Babu feel that his heart is throbbing very fast. He was sweating a little, and he was sweating because finally, after the confirmation of Dinesh Mukherjee, Bipin Babu is going to know that this incident was happened or not happened. He was at Ranchi in the year 1958 or not. So he was sweating a little. He was perspired. So now Dinesh Mukherjee came and spoke. Hello, yes, I have got it. He said that, hello, yes, in the year 1958, I have got it. I would been Ranchi. I had been out twice. Okay, in the year 1958, I had been out twice. Two times I went for some. I went somewhere. So Mr. Bipin Babu said, where? Okay, you went twice in the year 1958. So where you went? Once in February, nearby to Krishnanagar to a nephew's wedding. So in the 1958 of February, in the month February, I went to Krishnanagar for my nephew's wedding. Nephew here, that means brother's son's wedding. And then, so first trip was in Krishnanagar of Dinesh Mukherjee. And then, okay, where you went? But you would know about this one. So in replied, Dinesh Mukherjee told him, you would know, you should be know, you know that we were together, because if you go through part one, you can see that Parimal Ghosh told him that there is a quarrel took place between you and Dinesh Mukherjee. So Dinesh Mukherjee surely said that you would know about this one, the trip to Ranchi, that we were together, the trip to Ranchi. You were there too, and you are, that means Bipin Babu were there too. That's all. But what's all this alluding about? Then he asked the Bipin Babu that why are you doing this investigation? Here the word alluding, that means investigation. No, I just wanted to. Anyway, thanks. And in reply, Bipin Babu said, nothing, nothing. I just wanted to. And he was trying, he want to speak something, but he stopped his conversation. Anyway, thanks for the information. Bipin Babu slammed the receiver down and gripped his head with his hands. So Bipin Babu slammed the receiver. Slammed, that means forcefully he put the receiver down and gripped his head and touched his head with his hands. He felt his head swimming, and he felt that his head was swimming. That means he cannot understand anything what is going on. A chill seemed to spread over his body. A chill seemed to spread over his body. That means his body is becoming cold. There were sandwiches in his tiffin box. So this incident from where he called Dinesh Mukherjee from the office. So there were sandwiches in his tiffin box. So he took tiffin with his, and in that tiffin box there were sandwiches. But he didn't eat them. But he could not eat all the sandwiches brought by him into the tiffin box. Why? Because total confusion was there into his mind. Because he lapsed his memory, he forget one part of his memory, one incident from his memory. He had lost his appetite after this conversation. He can't eat, so he had lost his appetite. Appetite here, that means hunger. He lost his hunger. So students, that's all in part 2. Now what happened to Mr. Babu, and in this story what happened to reveal this, we will go through part 3. So in our next video I will discuss what happened next with Bipin Babu in part 3. Thank you and assalamu alaikum.